Doctors Without Borders, also known internationally by our French name Médecins Sans Frontières, or MSF, is an independent medical humanitarian organization. Founded in 1971, MSF won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1999. Today, we have some 33,000 staff on the ground in roughly 70 countries. We work in communities affected by war, natural disasters, disease outbreaks, chronic neglect, and other crises, treating people based on medical needs alone, regardless of race, religion, or political affiliation. MSF is set up to respond to emergencies and provide free, high-quality medical care to people in need. We have an extensive network of aid workers in projects all over the world, and emergency experts that stand ready to fly out at a moment's notice. MSF's logistical system sends medicines and materials as quickly as possible so our staff can start treating patients. The vast majority of MSF's funding comes from private donors, not governments. This financial independence means we can make prompt operational decisions based first and foremost on the medical needs on the ground, not on political considerations. Every day, MSF teams treat patients in a range of emergency situations. Nearly a third of our projects are in active conflict zones. Here, civilians are caught in the crossfire, unable to reach the healthcare services they urgently need. MSF leaders negotiate access to communities where the needs are greatest. We communicate with all parties to a conflict to explain MSF's guiding principles of neutrality, impartiality, and independence, along with the medical services we offer. In many places, this allows MSF to operate where other organizations can't. When an earthquake, hurricane, or other natural disaster hits, our emergency teams evaluate the situation on the ground to identify the most urgent needs. We then start treating the wounded and reinforcing battered medical systems as quickly as possible. For people affected by conflicts or natural disasters, we offer critical services such as surgery, maternal and pediatric care, vaccinations, and mental health counseling. We also focus on the particular needs of people displaced from their homes, including treatment for malnutrition, emergency obstetrical complications, and sexual violence. In 2014 and 15, MSF took the lead in responding to the massive Ebola outbreak in West Africa. At the same time, MSF teams elsewhere were building on years of experience and responding to diseases such as malaria, cholera, measles, HIV, and tuberculosis, diseases that are just as lethal as bombs and bullets if left untreated. For MSF, it's not enough to only treat the medical needs our teams see. We also advocate for our patients. That could mean drawing attention to whatever circumstances created urgent medical needs, or meeting with government officials or other members of the international community to push for patients to have access to healthcare. The message is always the same. People at risk should be able to access healthcare, and medical workers, even in active conflict zones, must be allowed to provide it. MSF also believes that life-saving medicines and vaccines must be affordable and accessible to people who need them most. MSF's Access campaign pushes governments and the pharmaceutical industry to put patients before profits when it comes to drug pricing and research and development priorities. Accountability is one of MSF's core principles, something that connects to everything else we do. We're extremely grateful for the support we receive from donors around the world, and we provide as much information about our work as we can through various platforms, including regular donor communications, the news media, social media, and public events. The ongoing support of our donors, together with the profound commitment of our aid workers, will allow MSF to provide independent and impartial assistance to people in crises for a long time to come. The future holds many challenges for people around the world, but we also know what's possible when we go where we're most needed with the materials we need to deliver life-saving medical care.